What if I wasn't here, but instead I was there, floating right in front of you? Holographics, bro. They're coming. Greetings, programs. Trace here for DNews. Yes, I am really here. I am not a hologram yet. There may soon be a day where I'll just pop into your living room, into the palm of your hand, or I'll walk alongside you down the street. The idea behind holographic technology has been around since the late 1940s, when British scientist Denis Gabor coined the word hologram from the Greek words meaning whole message. But those are a little different. We've got these laser-based holograms on everything from novelty toys to credit cards and money. Since the post-war years, holograms have jumped out of that little two-dimensional window into three-dimensional space. The most famous one recently was probably from last year's Coachella, where a holo Tupac made an appearance. But the most widespread recognition of holographic technology is on Star Trek with the holodeck, a place where anyone can put themselves anywhere thanks to 3D touchable holograms. We are not quite there yet, though people in the business of holograms do think we'll see a holodeck someday. But so far, all holographic technology is really just visual trickery. The Coachella Tupac wasn't floating in 3D space, but projected onto an angled, see-through Mylar screen, a technique that's been used since the Victorian times with mirrors and glass. It's essentially the same thing you'd see at Disney's Haunted Mansion, if maybe less shiny and happy. Holograms work because our eyes are tricked into seeing something closer to us than it is. Using a concave mirror, the hologram appears to separate from the projector, but it's just an optical illusion. Similar to 3D television in movies, if you only had one eye and you didn't use both, it wouldn't be floating anywhere. Another holographic problem is the brain's tendency to see problems in the world around us. The uncanny valley is something we've talked about a bit on DNews, but if a hologram looks real but isn't done quite right, the brain doesn't process it properly, and we become uncomfortable or afraid and sometimes even sick. We know something's wrong, but our primitive cerebrum can't comprehend it, and we experience this fear response. We've also yet to figure out how to get rid of something to project onto. I've seen holographics try to use smoke, water, see-through screens, mannequins, animatronics, but they're basically movies on a different type of screen. While someday we'll be able to project ourselves out of a droid or whatever, we're still in the dark on that one and we can't touch it at all. That's like a whole nother thing. So what do you think? Are holographics worth it? Thanks for watching DNews today. Holla at you, boy. Come find us on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+ to see some behind-the-scenes stuff, suggest stories, or just chat with us. Me, Anthony, and Lacey are around. Why aren't you? Thanks for tuning in. See you next time.